Bruins send it back in. Panthers have 14 back-to-backs this year, so we asked Maurice about managing his games played as he gets older. It shouldn't be a problem this year. Rodrigues, score! Looks like it might be a goal and a penalty on Florida. After the fact, Korpisalo was run over, but I think the goal will stand. And now, buckets are off. Brazo grabs Tkachuk. There's Bennett as the Rat comes on the ice.
Obviously, Boston's not happy with that. You know, the play there is Korpisalo gets run over right after that goal happens. The 6-2 game, you know there was going to be a response from Boston. No surprise, Trent Frederick's right in the middle of it.
And like a piece of Tkachuk.
Trying to get a hold of Tkachuk. Gets under everybody's skin.
Here comes Morai to grab Tkachuk.
Frederick. If you're Tkachuk, you want no part of this right now in a 6-2 game.
So again, I think it's a goal good and a penalty on the Panthers for running into Korpisalo after it goes in. Rodrigues wants the goal. He ripped the wrist shot. And then Korpisalo was taken out.
Everybody's hugging each other there. Nothing wrong with that.
Swayman is taking a look at Korpisalo to see if he has to come in. Looks like Korpisalo is going to be okay. Looks like he kind of tapped his head there. So maybe he said there was a little bit of head contact.
Good response from Boston, though. I like that. Showing a little fire. Goalie gets run over. Korpisalo looks okay. Stay in the game.
The Bruins have been a little flat tonight overall, right? I mean, Frederick tried early. You saw Zadora try early, but here's the goal. It's in. Clearly in. Off the stick of Lori. And then, bam! That's hard head contact on Korpisalo. Bennett.
Yeah, you can see Bennett too. He's driving the net. Carlo's kind of pushing Bennett as well. I think Bennett just runs out of real estate. He has nowhere else to go after Rodrigues absolutely fires this one. And you're right, that goes off a Lori stick. Korpisalo has a tough time picking that up. You can almost see Bennett. He tries to stop, but that's a penalty. There's no question about it. You got to know where you are on the ice.
Steve Jackson, our former NHL referee, rules interpreter. And so, Dave, this could be a good goal, correct? And
Boston penalty, number 11. Two-minute minor, roughing. Florida penalty, number 19. Two-minute minor, roughing. Florida penalty, number 9. Two-minute minor, roughing.
So it looks like Boston's going to come away with a power play after this, but the goal does stand.
Dave Jackson, I wonder, Dave, that was a pretty violent run into the goaltender. Can you call more than two? What are the options for an NHL referee in that situation?
Well, I like the call as two. You can tell it's all about judgment from the referee's perspective. If you deem that intentional in the crease, that's a 5-and-game for charging. But as Callie said, he simply ran out of real estate. He was going wide. He was pushed away by the Boston defender. He tried to cut inside, realized too late that he had no room, made a small attempt to avoid the goaltender. But ultimately, you've got to avoid that goaltender. It's not the goaltender's job to avoid you. So I like the he called him for roughing. You're not calling interference because the play's dead. Puck's in the net. So he called him for roughing. Could have been charging, but it's a good call. I think 2 minutes is the justified call.
The Bruins have a power play as a result. The extracurricular went to the roughing calls to Frederick and Tkachuk. I think in the end, they probably wanted to give the Bruins a power play. They probably deserved it.
Well, they definitely deserved it after Bennett just ran your goalie over. You definitely deserve the power play. So, right call by the refs there.
But again, it's 6-2 now, Florida, so the Bruins are once again in a 4-goal hole.